Michele Glass here. Our job for this video is to look at the muscles of the thoracic cavity on the front side here and the abdominopelvic cavity as well. So we've already looked at the deltoid as part of our muscles of the back and shoulder. Remember, it is responsible for abducting the humerus. The muscle that's the antagonistic to that is the pectoralis major. So let's take a look at that one next. You can see it here on both sides. Notice that it is inserting here at the humerus, and it does have the opposite action to the deltoid. So the pectoralis major is going to adduct the humerus, so bring it into the midline. That's not all. It also flexes the humerus and does medial rotation, so depending on where that muscle is contracting. We can see again that the insertion is the humerus and that it's going to originate at the clavicle, the sternum, and also costal cartilages of some of our ribs, like ribs 2 to 6, I think. Also in the thoracic cage, you can see sitting right on top here of the rib cage, you have a muscle called the serratus anterior. I can pop this chest piece off. That will help you to see. Let me see here. Okay. Serratus anterior is that layer of muscle sitting right on top of the rib cage. So that's the anterior part of its name. I'm not sure if you can see it better there. The serratus part of its name is because it looks serrated, because it does insert on each of the rib cages, each of the ribs. Okay. Also, since I've popped this off, we can see that there are muscles in between each of the ribs. These are called intercostals. There are two sets. There is an internal intercostal set of muscles that I'm showing you here. It's a little bit harder to see, but there will also be an external intercostal set of muscles, and I'll show you those on a different model. Going back to this view here, we can see muscles of the abdominopelvic cavity. So your rectus abdominis is this muscle at the front. So it's called rectus because of the directionality of those muscle fibers. That means straight. You can see on this side of the model, the rectus sheath is intact. And then you have what are called tendinous inscriptions, dividing the rectus abdominis into bulges. So that's what gives that characteristic six-pack abs look to your rectus abdominis. Okay, from the vertebral column coming around to the side, really holding those organs into the abdominal pelvic cavity, we can see next the external obliques. So these are called obliques because of the curvature of the muscle fibers. It's external because it's the outermost layer. If you're looking again at this piece here, you can see the inner layer is going to be the internal obliques. And then next, you're going to see the transverse abdominis, which is named because look at the directionality of those muscle fibers going in the transverse plane. So you have coming around from the vertebral column around the sides towards the front, you have three layers of muscles. The innermost is the transverse abdominis. In between is the internal oblique, and then the outermost is the external oblique. You can see these from this view here too. Let's see. All right. Hopefully you can see external oblique, internal oblique, and then closest to the organs there would be the transverse abdominis. It's coming all the way around here. Also on this model right here, you can see a small little piece of the diaphragm. The diaphragm is a muscle here that's separating the thoracic and abdominal pelvic cavities. It is a muscle that can be controlled both voluntarily and involuntarily. So we do need to make sure we can label that. Also where the ribs have been cut, again, you can see the intercostals. The internal is again closest to the internal organs, and then the external intercostal is on the outside of that. Intercostal means between ribs. And then remember, serratus anterior is on the outside of those intercostals.